breaking news at this hour on your screens in just a short while. The UltraTech Jaypee deal has been announced. In fact, we had Anshu just a short while ago giving the revised contours of the deal, but it has been signed and Jaypee Group will be selling their entire cement assets to UltraTech. It has been, we'll get the flashings going in just a short while and we'll try to get your reactions as well. But, you know, let me bring in someone who's been tracking this deal for a while. Nisha, this deal has been to and fro for a very long time. We've been tracking this. Jaypee needs to cut down its, 74,000 crore rupees of debt. So far, from the figures that we had from Anshu, why has the deal been revised and what will the contours be now? Does this mean that the debt amount that they were looking to cut down will be substantially reduced?
No, it's just less than 2% actually, Kritika, of the original deal that they had signed. It's only a minor tweaking that they had done because they didn't want one of the Karnataka units to really come in. So it's only a small difference as far as the entire deal dynamics is concerned. It's only just one unit that they didn't want really in this whole package of 22.4 million tons along with that 4 million tons which is under construction as well. So it's only a minor tweaking. It's going to be about 15,900 plus 470 crore rupees, and that's going to be the actual deal size instead of 16,500 plus 500 odd crore rupees. So that's the basic change and the difference that is there. And of course, the one who's really been bringing those amount of details, that is the final figures, has been Anshu, who's also there with us right now and will be taking us through more details. Anshu, would you also have details of why that Karnataka unit was left out of the entire deal finally?
As per sources, I understand that there was some commercial issue from both the sides on not going ahead with that Karnataka plant. So as reported, 15,900 crore will be the deal size for 17.2 million ton of cement business of Jaypee Associates. There has been an announcement made on the exchanges for the same. There will be 9 units which will be part of this deal, and this will take up about a year's time to execute this deal. And the last one in this deal will be the Balaji unit in Andhra Pradesh, which is 5 million ton unit of Jaypee UltraTech. And of course, this will go ahead only once regulatory hurdles like CCI clearance and amendment of MMDR is done in the Rajya Sabha. Back to you.
So Anshu, just hang in over there. Anshu is in fact standing outside that very crucial board meeting. But let me bring in a Prakash Diwan as well. Prakash, you now know the basic contours of the deal. The deal has finally been signed. What is the upside that you're expecting for Jaypee and UltraTech? How significant would this be in actually pushing UltraTech's plans going ahead?
So very clearly, it definitely is extremely positive for UltraTech because this was part of the geographical expansion that they badly need to, you know, come into the number one position. And the fact that, you know, from a 66 million ton to almost like closer to 100 is what their goal is, or inorganically is what they were indicated they want to grow. And the south is something which is one of the fastest growing regions, and UltraTech would have to kind of compete with some of the more established players. So in that respect, this particular thing is a great fit. And the money that finally they have ended up paying also seems to be very much reasonable. It doesn't seem to be an overpriced kind of a thing.
Yeah.
Of course, the residual part of the deal could also follow through maybe, you know, after a subsequent round of negotiation, but that's a much smaller part.
How much of an issue do you expect the regulatory hurdles to be? Because there have been a lot of talks about how CCI will play spoil sport. How much of an issue are you expecting, you know, the overall competition norms to come in over here?
See, technically, the CCI is more worried about cartelization on pricing rather than, you know, somebody growing inorganically to cover a much wider reach and much wider, geography in the cement business. So I don't see that to be such a big hurdle at this point in time. And the fact that now the MMRDA thing also is cleared, you have absolute clarity on the fact that the value is lying with the captive mines that can also get transferred, without which it would have been a game, it would have been a deal breaker of sorts. So that covers most of the contentious issues for which this deal has been hanging fire for so long.
You know, Mr. Daga, a quick question to you with regards to the overall pricing of the deal. So, a little bit of rework over there, not that significant, but the Karnataka plant has been left out. The deal has been reworked to 15,900 crore rupees. What do you think is the reason for that largely? Prakash, can you hear me?
Yeah. So, you know, essentially that could be because the expectation of that particular unit was much higher from the JP group all the while. And that was something which was added on as part of this deal much later. So possibly, you know, there is a commercial angle to it. And probably the price negotiation would take, some sort of a this thing. And it's a much more recent plant, which means that even the debt on that particular unit would not probably be such a, matter of concern as much as the other ones are. So JP is in a hurry to clear this. Whereas the Karnataka piece probably, doesn't really
behove in
this thing. Yeah. So it's probably something where they have some time to buy. And then maybe they could get a better this thing from some other players as well.
And also, Prakash, Nisha Poddar joining in here. How much do you think will Andhra Pradesh really matter in the whole scheme of things? Because remember, Andhra Pradesh could be a cause of worry. The UltraTech as well as Jaypee Associates and their 5 million tons of cement unit that has been also acquired by UltraTech, that could create a CCI hurdle, do you think? Of course, you've said that CCI may not be too much of a hurdle. They must have already seen all the pros and cons there. But Andhra Pradesh is also an oversupply market in that sense. How much do you think that will be an issue and also the capacity utilization to the optimum over there?
See, very, very valid point, Nisha, because, we have seen a huge convergence of focus and attention on these resources for Karnataka, for Andhra. But very clearly, there would be some sort of a commitment that UltraTech would probably make that they would use that as a manufacturing base, as more of a production base and not necessarily, use it just as a market to sell that. So that could probably start supplying a lot of, cement to the southern part of the country, which otherwise doesn't really have too many resources other than these few pockets. So largely we have a lot of cement concentration in the west and a little bit in the northwest, but there's nothing much in the eastern side. And that's where probably, Andhra could start supplying. And that's a very competitive, very high margin market at this point in time. So there could be some commitments that conditionalities that CCI could put and UltraTech would readily agree to.
You know, Nisha, we should bring in Anshu here as well, because let's just recap. 15,900 crore rupee, the deal has been cut down to. The deal is for 17.2 million tons per annum. Okay, we actually have Atul Daga on the phone line. Thank you so much, Mr. Daga, for joining in. Big day for you. Yes, sir. But, there's been revised contours. Karnataka plant has been left out of the deal. The deal size has been cut down to 15,900 crore rupees. What was the large reason of this? And take us through the discussion and the final contours of the definitive agreement that you've signed with JP.
Yeah. So, hi. So, this will be now 21.2 million tons instead of 22.4 million tons that we were contemplating earlier, having dropped the Karnataka plant of 1.2 million tons. This was basically for various, findings that we had in our due diligence, which, conditions that we were requiring compliance, completion would not have been completed by the JP group in time, hence we have dropped that asset. So now the deal size, as you mentioned, is reduced to 15,900 crores and 21.2 million tons. So we are taking other assets, which is coastal Andhra, Madhya Pradesh, Himachal and UP.
So, Mr. Daga, I just wanted to understand how much time frame are you looking at to complete this particular acquisition? Because if MMDR Act is not really passed, then you'll have to go through the entire process of demerger, which JP Associates will do, and therefore that will be sold to UltraTech. So how much time frame are you looking at? And would the structure really change if MMDR Act really comes across?
Yeah, so we are quite hopeful that MMDR Act should get passed. Lok Sabha has already cleared it. It's now the moment Rajya Sabha convenes after the recess towards the end of this end of April. It should. There's no reason why the bill should not get cleared. So we will go through an asset purchase transaction only.
But Mr. Daga, give us a rough timeline. What is the timeline that you're working with to be able to actually complete this deal and integrate JP's assets with UltraTech?
I would give it 12 to 15 months, there are court processes involved. So,
And, since you spoke about the court processes and you spoke about MMDR Act, the one big issue is CCI. There have been a couple of reports suggesting that that may be an issue. Do you expect cartelization of cement, competition commission norms coming in and playing spoil sport in the deal?
No, as a matter of fact, if you look at the specific plants, since all our newer plants, and out of these two plants which we had signed up earlier and had to drop because MMDR, there was no clarity under MMDR, those two particular plants already had received the CCI clearance.
Yeah.
So there are other plants where markets which we are entering are totally new markets for us. So since they are relevant market, we are not the largest player in those markets, which I don't see a reason why we should not be able to get CCI clearance.
So, Mr. Daga, let's come to the specifics of the numbers then. Exactly how much are you giving to Jaypee Associates for this entire deal? And can you give us a breakup of the enterprise value in terms of how much money or how much debt are you taking over from Jaypee Associates and how much is going by way of cash from your pocket?
Total, as I mentioned, 15,900 crores. Out of that, 11,500 crores is the debt we will take over. Existing debt will get refinanced at our credit rating, as compared to the present terms, which I believe are far quite attractive. And the balance amount of amount will be pumped in by way of additional debt that we will raise on our balance sheet.
So in how much time are you going to pay the cash component? Is that going to be the first upfront cash component?
No, nothing upfront. Everything will be paid on the date of closing.
All right. So one of the lenders had said that in 3 years, the entire debt that you are taking will be repaid. Can you throw more light? Is that true? And how are you going to repay? And you also said that as per your credit rating. So can you, Mr. Daga, also tell us what will be your finance charge once you take over that debt? How much money will you land up saving on that and your debt equity levels post this deal as well?
If I were to look at my debt equity levels, we would rise to about when we complete the acquisition, we should be somewhere around 2.5 debt equity. My apologies. Debt EBITDA would be 2.5, and debt equity would be about close to 1.
Okay.
So therefore, your total debt goes to.
So this is about 15,900 crores of debt coming in,
yeah.
And by the time that debt comes in, we would be virtually out of all other debt. So this would be the only debt that would be left on the balance sheet.
And your finance charge on an average would be about how much, Mr. Daga?
So you need to look at a rate of about 9%.
All right. And in terms of the competitive thing, tell me, as far as the cost component is concerned, would you be spending more in terms of realigning the cost structure of the acquired assets as per UltraTech?
Yes, there are lots of improvements that we intend to bring about.
So how much capex could that really entail, Mr. Daga, over and above the cost?
Not necessarily capex. There are a lot of procurement efficiencies and improvement, working capital deployment, which will be done. So that should be able to revive the operation. And in a normal, when we do a detailed diligence on the plant, when our team gets in, they'll make a plan on where and how much capex requires to be done.
Mr. Daga, a quick sense of the overall capacity utilization of the overall 17.2 million tons that you're taking in. What are the current capacity?
One second. It's not 17.2, it is 21.2.
Correct. So 21.2 million ton is currently functioning at what capacity?
Four is obviously a non-operation.
Yeah, sorry. From that perspective, you're right. Four is not operational.
Yeah. So what is the current capacity utilization and by when?
They are sub 50% capacity utilization.
So by when will they come to UltraTech levels?
Give it a year after
a year
we take over. Come on.
Is it an additional capex that you're expecting to put in to be able to
There will be some minor capex, yes.
Minor.
Nothing significant to worry about.
Okay.
And when we talk about Andhra Pradesh, Mr. Daga, is that a worry for you? Because Andhra Pradesh is oversupplied market. And do you think a CCI concern over there as well? And how much time will the capacity utilization would be up to optimal over there?
So this plant that we are picking up is in the coastal Andhra area, which will be the hub of development. And I imagine that coastal Andhra will grow at a pace faster than other regions in the country in the next 2 to 5 years, with the state making some serious efforts on the development, the new Andhra Pradesh, that is, the city of Amravati coming up, the new airports, etc., the development that is taking place, will definitely usher in good days for cement industry in that state. We are not present in the coastal Andhra, so I don't expect any competition commission issues from our perspective.
Right. Also, Mr. Daga, in terms of brand, and of course, UltraTech brand commands a premium in pricing for cement, and Jaypee Associates would be lower than that on an average 20 to 30 rupees per bag is what we do gather.
Sorry, I lost you on a bit.
All right, no problem. I'll repeat that. So in terms of the branding of UltraTech, you definitely command a premium on cement prices than compared to Jaypee Associates cement. So how are you going to, and how much time will you be able to command the same premium, and what will be the whole rebranding exercise that you are looking out for in the timeline for that?
So it should take us about 2 months after takeover to go through the rebranding process, not more than 2 months, which technically requires whatever quality improvements that we want to bring about, increasing the dealer network. Of course, we take over a substantial dealer network also. Mm-hmm. And setting up our systems and processes, doing the logistics tie-ups in those markets. Because most of the markets are newer markets for us.
Oh, definitely. And the coal mine that Jaiprakash
is... We are not taking any of the coal mines.
All right. And why have you not taken Bhilai unit? Is there any particular reason for that as well?
No, that was not part of the deal. That was not on sale in any case.
And Andhra Cement has been also buzzing on the news that UltraTech could be interested in that. It's a group company. Are you looking at...
having done this transaction, which gives us enough share in the market in Andhra Pradesh, I don't think we would look at any more asset in the coastal Andhra area.
Mr. Daga, before we let you go, take us through, once you absorb Jaypee Associates completely, the entire 21.2 million tons comes in. What is the total capacity, the total debt figure, the total capacity utilization basically that will remain on UltraTech?
So we'll have total capacity above 90 million tons.
Okay.
And debt, I have already mentioned, by the time that the deal gets completed, we would have the debt that we are taking over for this transaction. That will be the amount of debt that we will have on our balance sheets.
Okay.
And, another point that you raised, capacity utilizations, as the demand, we are, looking at demand picking up.
Exactly.
October, December was good. January, March should be good. And the next year should be good, we assume.
So you're expecting the demand to get better going ahead in the next coming month? Because that's been an issue, specifically as far as Jaypee Cement is concerned.
No, we are expecting the demand to improve further do good for the industry in fiscal 17 onwards. So capacity utilization, which... today are at sub 50, will start rising as I mentioned earlier.
So to how much would you be able to take it up to the 75-80% comfort level?
That will take some time, and it's very difficult for me to guess how things will pan out.
But what is the turnaround plan that you have for the cement business completely?
I'm sorry?
What is the turnaround plan in that case that you have put in place so far for the cement business of Jaypee?
So we should be looking at a year's turnaround time to get the plants operational at the efficiency levels that we operate. And now it depends upon the demand pickup that should surface in the markets. If demand pickup happens the way we are looking at it, it's coming in from all infrastructure story that the government is building upon. if the demand story goes along, these plants should also start going up to the 60-70% capacity utilization by the end of 1 year of taking over.
Okay, quickly, Mr. Daga, what is the exact EBITDA per ton? Because I have mixed figures here. What is the exact EBITDA per ton that Jaypee Associates 21.2 million tons business that you're taking in is operating at this point in time?
They are sub 600.
Sub 600. So once you merge the two, do you know what would be the combined EBITDA per ton in that case?
So they are operating at sub 600. I am operating at 1,000 rupees in EBITDA per ton.
So that would bring down or average out your EBITDA per ton for the next immediate quarters and then start...
Yeah, it will. It will naturally, it will have a minor dent.
Right. And how much is the per ton valuation that you have paid?
About $107 per ton.
All right. And finally, I would like to know, 90 million tons done. When are you reaching 100 million tons? That has been your target for a long time.
I don't know how this 100 million target is being talked about, but we will continue to grow. If the industry is growing, demand is growing, we will definitely want to keep growing. So let us absorb this 20 million tons, make it work, and then we'll get into our organic expansion or any inorganic opportunity that comes our way. Let the balance sheet also take a breather before we get going again.
Atul, getting back to the EBITDA per ton question, as you said, it will average out to an extent for some time, but you're looking at a turnaround time of 1 year. So can we say that after 1 year, it will go back or JP's business of or the EBITDA per ton will go back to, will go to UltraTech rates?
It's, you know, it's very difficult for me to predict it at this this stage. It all depends upon how the demand curve looks up. If demand goes the way, let's say if the demand starts rising at double digits, then yes, give it 1 year, it will be there.
All right, Mr. Daga, thanks so much for joining us and giving us all the details on this large transaction that